Should we drag the net?
Ask the carpenter. He knows everything about fish.
Pull it in.
Pull it in? It's only been in the water.
Pull it in.
What kind of man are you that you can command the fish in the water?
Come with me, Peter. I'll make you a fisher of men. His birth changed the way time is measured.
In Bethlehem, kings came and bowed down to you. Those men did not travel all that way, following that star, without the will of God guiding them.
His life changed the destiny of billions.
Can you heal, my son?
Do you believe I can help you?
Yes.
Rise up and walk.
His death changed the course of history.
You don't stop him. He's been to bring Rome down on us all. We could see to it that he becomes a problem for some of his own. He can solve the problem for us.
Do you claim to be the son of God?
It is you who says it.
Blasphemy!
Bow down to me.
Away with you, Satan! My God! Why have you forsaken me?
Gary Oldman as Pontius Pilate.
I give you Jesus of Nazareth!
I'd rather have a murderer.
Debra Messing as Mary Magdalene.
I don't know.
We saw him crucified. We buried him ourselves.
Yes, sir.
Jacqueline Bissette as the Virgin Mary.
How is that enough?
That's where I was born.
To die?
And Jeremy Sisto as Jesus.
I have to give everything.
Hey everyone, welcome to another Catholic Movie Monday here on Catholicism Wow. Today, we are going to talk about the 1999 television miniseries, Jesus. Jesus starred Jeremy Sisto and Gary Oldman and G.W. Bailey, who you might remember as Captain Harris from the Police Academy movies. Debra Messing plays Mary Magdalene, and Jacqueline Bissette plays the Holy Mother, the Virgin Mary. This movie aired, well, as a miniseries. It aired in two parts, but if you watch it on DVD, you can watch it for free on Vudu with commercials. You can also buy it for cheap through YouTube. I'm not sure if it's available for free on YouTube, but it is available for free with ads on Vudu. On Vudu and on YouTube, it is shown in its original two-part format. On the DVD, it's edited together as a 1 3-hour movie, and I think it really watches a lot better that way. You really can't tell where part one ends and part two begins. It's seamless. It's a perfect edit, and I think the DVD might have... No, that's a lie. There are two DVD versions. If you get this version, it does not include an alternate ending scene. If you get, however, this version, it does have an alternate ending scene, which I'm not sure if it was part of the original broadcast or not. The alternate ending scene, and we will get this out of the way right now, is really nothing special. To be honest, I don't even know what it is. It's Jeremy Sisto. Jesus ascends into heaven at the end of the movie, and then it cuts to the modern day. And Jeremy Sisto, who played Jesus through the entire movie, comes walking out of a building. He's got shorter hair, but he still has a beard. He is dressed very modern. He looks very modern. He walks across the street to this group of school children and greets them with smiles. And, you know, they walk off into the sunset with, you know, with Jesus playing with these children. That's all it is. It's really, I don't get it. I don't get the scene. I don't know why it's there, and to be honest, I really don't know if the movie plays better or worse with it. It's just an anomaly. It's just kind of there. And Yeah, so, I mean, if you want this scene, don't want this scene, those are the two editions of the DVD that have it, don't have it. And yeah, I mean, I just don't get that scene. So the movie does not tell the Christmas story. The movie starts out with showing some scenes of the Crusades, showing some scenes of the church burning a witch at the stake. Or a heretic, but you're led to believe that it's a witch, but they're burning some female heretic at the stake. And then World War One. And they all are, all the scenes are referencing the name of Jesus. So in the first scene, the Crusaders are riding into battle, screaming in the name of Jesus Christ, and then it cuts to the scene with the heretic being burned at the stake, and the bishop is saying, you know, in the name of our Christ, in the name of Christ our Lord in heaven, I execute you for false teaching and heresy and whatever the charges are that he reads. And then it cuts to World War One, and there's a soldier dying on the battlefield and he's crying out for Jesus. And then it cuts to Jesus waking up from a bad dream. So Jesus is having a premonition of the future and how his name will be used in the future. Then it shows Jesus and Joseph at Lazarus's house, and they are doing some work. It's never really clear what kind of work they're doing. They're doing some kind of repairs there at Lazarus's house. It's mentioned that Lazarus is a cousin and that Lazarus's two sisters, Mary and Martha. Martha has a crush on Jesus and hopes to one day be Mrs. Jesus Christ, which obviously isn't going to happen. And there is a scene later where Jesus has to tell her, listen, Martha, you can't be with me. You don't want me. My life is not my own, he says. Other than skipping the Christmas story, it's a pretty decent blending of the Gospels. We see the woman caught in the act of adultery and Jesus saying, let he who is without sin be the first to cast a stone. We see the turning water into wine. We see the temptation in the desert where Satan is played first by a beautiful woman who then transforms into Jeronin Crowby. Or Krabby, I don't know how to say his name, but he was the actor. He was the villain in the James Bond movie, The Living Daylights. He was the villain in the Johnny Franco in the Dolph Lundgren version of The Punisher. He was the villain ultimately in The Fugitive with Harrison Ford. He was the other doctor that hired the one-armed man. So if you haven't seen this movie that's now 30 years old, I've just spoiled it for you. You're welcome. So yeah, I mean, he's been around the block and usually playing a villain. And in this movie, he plays Satan. And there's a lot of visual trickery. A lot of it is visually interesting with the temptation in the desert. For television in the late 1990s, this had very decent special effects. For television in the late 1990s. Don't come in the comment section saying the special effects sucked. They do now. They didn't 25 years ago on television, you know? So yeah, by theatrical film standards today, yes, they suck. But by television standards 25 years ago, they were pretty okay. They put a lot of work and a lot of effort and a lot of money into this. One of the best parts about this movie, and I've said this since it was brand new, when it first aired on television, I was in the army, everybody that I knew had watched it, and everybody that I knew hated it. They just saw things in it that I didn't see, like Martha's unrequited love for Jesus somehow tarnishing Jesus's divinity. That doesn't make any sense. Jesus was a man. Jesus, of course, probably would have had women that wanted to marry him and wanted to get wifed up to him. It's not on him. I mean, he does the right thing in the movie. It's not like the movie portrays Jesus as having a secret wife. No, he tells her, that he's not for that, that's not his calling in this life. So I don't understand what people were upset about, and I didn't then, and I still don't. But one of the greatest things about this movie, and I've been saying it for the last, 25 years since it was on television, 24 years since it was on television in 1999, it is the first time, now not the only time, because Jonathan Rumi on The Chosen does this very, very, very well. But in 1999, this was the first time that I had seen any actor portray Jesus with any kind of personality at all, any kind of humanity. Jesus's full divinity is on display in this movie, but so is his full humanity, and that's not something that you generally get from movies about the life of Christ. You don't get to know him. You don't get the sense of this being a man. He's always portrayed as a figure. And in this movie, Jeremy Sisto very much plays Jesus as a man, and it's great. The 12 disciples are obviously his friends. They're not just his students. They're not just his followers. They are his closest compadres in this movie. And there's even a scene where the disciples go and Jesus go into a town, and they've been walking for who knows how long, out in the sun, out in the heat, out in the desert, and they see a fountain, a pool, a drinking fountain. And they run over to this well, and they start to drink, and Jesus is drinking, and they start having a water fight right there at this watering hole. And that's something that, yes, I firmly believe Jesus did things like that with his friends. Jesus did things like that with his disciples. You know, at the wedding in Canaan, the wedding in Cana, he's not just sitting around waiting for somebody to say, hey, we're out of wine. He's dancing and drinking and carrying on and having a wonderful time. Having a wonderful time at a party. At a party that he was invited to, and that he drug John and Andrew along to with him. And then he turns the water into wine, and that's when John and Andrew know, because John and Andrew first saw Jesus at his baptism, and they saw him glow, and they saw the sky open up and the Holy Spirit descend, and God, this is my son in whom I am well pleased. They saw all of that, and they were like, this is the Messiah. So they followed him around. And when he did his first miracle at the wedding feast, they knew it was him. And so that's when they go and they tell the others. And then Jesus starts calling them, and it's wonderful. All the disciples, the four most principal players in this movie, Jeremy Sisto, Gary Oldman, who plays Pontius Pilate, G.W. Bailey, who plays Livio, who was a real historical figure. He was a real, like a Roman scribe, but he was also most probably Caesar's spy, and in this movie he is portrayed as a spy. He was probably sent to Judea, to to gather dirt on what's going on and report back to Caesar. And he's a very slimy, very unlikable character, very much like Captain Harris. G.W. Bailey does a fantastic job. And Debra Messing as Mary Magdalene. All four of them turn in just wonderful, just fantastic performances. Everything that you would expect from these actors. Gary Oldman as Pontius Pilate is everything Gary Oldman is, and everything. He's wonderful. And Jeremy Sisto has the honor of being one of only two actors who have ever had the honor of playing both Jesus Christ and Batman. The other actor was Christian Bale, and he was in a movie called Mary, Mother of Jesus, which is what we'll talk about next week. Jeremy Sisto did not play Batman in live action, but he did do the voice of Batman in the animated film Justice League: The New Frontier, and he's a wonderful Batman in that. So those are my thoughts on Jesus. I definitely think everybody should watch this. Definitely go on YouTube and look up the soundtrack. The soundtrack is wonderful. The soundtrack features a Leanne Rimes song, I Need You. It's got DC Talk covering the song Spirit in the Sky. There's a Jackie Velasquez song on there. It's a wonderful soundtrack full of great, wonderful music that goes along with this great, wonderful movie. This is before The Chosen. This was the best, in my opinion, portrayal of Jesus Christ before or since. And The Chosen is really, really amping up the bar, because The Chosen is wonderfully good. And maybe at one point I'll start breaking down and doing reviews of each season of The Chosen, but that show's been real hard for me to get into. As much as I do love it, I just don't have the time to dedicate to an ongoing episodic television series about the life of Christ. So I'm still way behind on The Chosen. I haven't even begun to watch episode 3, but the season 3. But the episodes that I have seen, it is a great and wonderful show, and I do hope to finally one day get through it and start reviewing each season. But yeah, so that's my Catholic Movie Monday for this week. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, like this video, share it with your friends, subscribe to the channel, help me out, do all the YouTube things, and we'll see you next time.